Hello, friends. Happy Friday. My name is Duke. The Bump has event starting. Castle in the Darkness livestream. This is Castle in the Darkness. This is a cool game that came out in February. I've beat the game, put a lot of time into it, got all the Chivos, those hot Chivos, started a new game plus game, haven't finished that one yet, but I'm going to start a brand new game for the purposes of the livestream. This is a retro 2D exploration platformer, kind of a Metroidvania, not really, I wouldn't go that far in the description. It has some similarities, but let's jump into it. I probably need to click in the window again. It's been a while since I've done this, so please forgive all the usual buffoonery. I might do New Game Plus eventually, but for now, let's just start a regular old new game. Kingdom of Alexandria. Hey, Bippo. So you're the last remaining Royal Guard. I just remembered that I forgot to change the game and the title on Twitch. Probably should have done that before I started streaming, because I'm sure that the tweet that went out still says it's offline. So let me do that real quick. One moment. This game was made by Matt Kapp, who is the main artist on The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. This is sort of a side project he's been working on in his spare time, or worked on in his spare time, I guess. Alright, am I even logged in? God, it's been so long since I've used Twitch. Let's see. Edit. Oh wait, that's me. I don't want to hear myself. Not yet. Not time for that yet, Duke. Let's see. By the way, I'm probably going to call this game Castle in the Sky at least once before the end of the stream, because that's the natural thing that comes after Castle in the is the word sky, so apologies for that. And let me tweet the link out real quick. Pretty good music in this game. I believe it was all made by the developer, Matt Kapp. Enjoy that for just a moment. All right. I think we're ready to actually do this thing. Hello to Private Steve and Citron Van in the chat room. Good to see all y'all. Alright, so this game, much like Shovel Knight, is very, very old school, deliberately so. There are literally two buttons. It's a two-button game. Well, two buttons and a D-pad. You have jump, and you have attack. You have a health bar up in the top left-hand corner, and there is a money counter up at the top. Let's see if we can save this town from the monsters. If you don't kill that zombie, he actually turns this guy into a zombie, which is pretty cool. But we saved him, so we get rewarded with money that I do not have access to. Can go into houses. possible to climb some roofs. That seems like a hint that they would specifically give me at a time when I can jump on a roof. I can't jump up here, though. There may be an item I acquire later in the game that lets me make that jump. So when you start out, you have a pretty pathetic little sword here, without much much range or power to it, but it's good for dispatching these easy early monsters. Oh, look at that. But we can't jump on this roof. Just those couple of specific roofs. Roofs are the ones we can jump on. So this game doesn't have a map, which is probably the biggest thing that distinguishes it from a Metroidvania. This is a checkpoint. You can save your game, and you can also equip items here. Let's go and do the equip menu real quick. Hello, Lord Tamar. This is our equip menu. We have the Guard Sword, which is the world's worst sword, apparently. It's a good one to start out with. Times are tough, so we're stuck using the guard armor. No magic yet. No relics, no items, not much of anything. We have 4 hit points. Oh, it's okay, Bippo. I'll just use the first time you said hello to me to sync the chat. That'll be fine. Alright, so let's see if we can fill some of those menus up with items. Seems like another hint that they would specifically give me right before I use it. Some enemy bullets can be hit back at them. And she should have kept running. That's okay, she was scared. I understand. And here we have boss number one. There are a lot of bosses in this game. And I get hit immediately by the easiest boss. And it did half my health. Worth of damage. Right, drop that loot. I have beaten this game before Citron Van, but it's been a few months since I played this game, so I'm sort of going back to it with fresh eyes. I probably remember most of the stuff in this game, but there might be some stuff that I forget. This guy gives you money if you hit his house a bunch of times. Just once, though. Yeah, that's useful to have, Bippo, the ability to play and watch. I often have a stream or a podcast going in the background while I play other games, usually The Binding of Isaac. So spikes are a one-hit kill in this game. They will probably be responsible for most of my deaths in this game. I forget what my death counter was in my first playthrough, but it was in the hundreds. This is kind of one of those games where you're expected to die a whole lot. But the checkpoints are pretty generous in terms of how often you find them. So, although it can be a difficult game, it is not an excruciating game. There are some really tough bosses to deal with, though. Can I not go back through that door? That's weird. Oh, this is where I fell the last time. Well, let's go ahead and save, since I'm at the checkpoint. Somebody helpfully put a platform here. Well, I could go back and heal again, but nah. Cracked blocks can only be broken while holding the Ares Gauntlet. That sounds like something that we will obtain. Hey, free money. Sweet. Yep, we don't have a gauntlet, so we can't do this. Hey, a chicken. Maybe we should beat up on it. See what happens. Oh! Yeah, let's get out of there. I have experimented with killing all of those attacking chickens, or trying to kill 1,000 of them and seeing if anything happens, and I don't believe anything happens. Is the guy on his tippy toes, or is that his entire lower body? Well, I think they're like his boots. I mean, this is kind of a low-resolution game, so you do kind of have to use your imagination. But I see like thigh-high boots or something. I mean, not like the sexy kind, you know, but like the armor kind. Oh. Well. Oh, hey, it keeps my death counter from the previous game. Well, that's handy. Wow. I'm almost at 666, too. Good timing. That's an auspicious number. Alright, is there anything I have to... I guess I can get that pot again. There are also a lot of secrets in this game that I may or may not remember. I did 100% this game in my first playthrough, and I did have to use a guide, but only to find two items. I found everything else without having to consult a guide. Let's see, can I get up here yet? No, I know there's some good secrets up there. Okay, well, what's in here? Costs 10 gold to stay the night. Stream delay is large. That sucks. How's the quality? Is Twitch being its usual crappy, laggy self? I mean, it's always laggy, but as long as you can see what's going on, then that's the important thing. See and hear what's going on. As long as it's not pausing every few seconds. Another handy tip there. Quality seems good. Awesome. Well, it is in a lower resolution window than usual, so that might be helping. This game has some weird... the resolutions options you get are pretty weird. It's in... The current resolution is 976 by 678, which is like sort of... Oops. Sort of halfway between widescreen and non-widescreen. But it might be a little easier on the old... internet than full 720p. Wrong sword? Sure, I'll buy that. I mean, I have the worst sword in the world, so I guess even the wrong sword would probably be an upgrade. Right or wrong, it's still an improvement. The weapon damage is still 1, but has a much longer reach. Moved out since I came back from tweeting. Excellent. Don't forget to equip it at a save point, or you can equip it right after you buy it. That's the only time you can equip weapons in this game without being at a save point. This guy's big. It is kind of an interesting choice that, shit. Gotta hit this guy in the head. Which makes sense, since I just got a hint about hitting guys in the head. It is kind of an interesting choice that you can only access your inventory at those save points. I mean, it's not really a huge deal, since the save points, like I said, they are pretty frequent, but it can be a minor annoyance sometimes, especially when there are certain bosses or enemies that are susceptible to certain magic or certain items that you have, and you have to backtrack to a save point just to equip it, but it's not a huge deal. At least it wasn't for me. Oh, hey, Harry's Gauntlet. This guy looks familiar. I believe he was in a movie of some kind. There's a secret over here. Money won't be a big deal in this game. I mean, really, there are only a small handful of items you can buy. For me, the big draw in this game... I forgot about that. I died so many times on those specific spikes. Like, you wouldn't even believe. Alright, so... What do I- okay, so I just have to buy my sword again. That's it. But, like I was saying, for me, the big draw in this game is just the massive size of the world. Like, there are so many places you can go, so many, like, connecting areas, and just a large variety of places. It kind of reminds me of- I mean, it was the reason I was so into La Mulana. But the problem with La Mulana was, I had no idea what I was supposed to do in that game. So for me, this game is kind of like a more forgiving version of La Mulana. Alright. Jump over these spikes, Duke. Do not just walk to the left. Good job. Everything is really well designed as far as the level layout goes. I never really got lost in this game. It can be kind of daunting just because, there's kind of a lot of backtracking and stuff. But I like this kind of exploration game. Like, it's not really, secret up here. Oh yeah, we can't jump up here yet. Grab that money though. Sorry. Oh god. I need to actually let me raise my window up a little bit. It's a little low on my screen. My microphone is blocking it. No, I never streamed or Let's Play La Mulana. Here's my experience with La Mulana. I saw a website do a review of it, and I thought, wow, this game's really awesome. And I downloaded it, and I tried to play it. And I basically got nowhere. Like, I couldn't figure out what I was supposed to do in that game. So I tried to find a walkthrough, and I found Deceased Crab's Let's Play of the game. I was like, oh wow, this is awesome. I'll use this to figure out how to get past this part I'm stuck on. And then I would do that, and then 10 minutes later, I was like, okay, now I don't know what to do again. So I go back to his Let's Play, I'd watch the part of the Let's Play, figure out what I had to do, move on, get stuck again, and repeat ad nauseum. So eventually I just gave up and I just watched the LP instead of playing the game. And that's what got me into LP. Cool story, bro. But if you haven't watched Deceased Crab's LP of the game, highly recommend it. It's a pretty good time. First one anyway. I know he went back to the game a couple times and I didn't watch those, so I cannot vouch for their quality. Yeah, La Mulana is one of those games, kind of reminds me of like Simon's Quest. Oh god. Castlevania 2. Alright. If I can get past this without dying. Where the puzzles are just so abstruse, I don't see how anyone can ever figure them out without looking it up. Ah, man, I don't have the museum key yet. Dang it, I forgot I needed that. Okay, well, I'll come back. Now, the fastest thing to do would be to just die and go back to the checkpoint, but, that's a coward's way out. Yeah, I gave the remake a shot, and I kind of had the same issue, Lord Tamar. The remake did seem pretty good, though. Stop messing with the cute chicken. Sorry, Bippo. He's got a couple of them now. The La Mulana LPs. Yeah, I know he did. I think he did the original a couple times, and then he did the remake once, I believe. I kind of want to go back and watch that again now. It's been a while. Do not enter sewer pipes. I don't know who Letov is, but his advice is pretty good. Oh god. This guy seems familiar too. Oh god. Man, I do not like his mouth when he opens it. He goes from being a cute, big, chubby dinosaur guy to being kind of an evil satanic monster. Alright, boss number 2 destroyed. He's a little loud. Really? That was one of the reasons I liked Deceased Crab. He seemed like one of the calmer, less players to me. I mean, up until you get to the Hell Temple, of course. Alright, so now that I saved, I'm gonna say, screw Letov. I'm going to see what's in that pipe. I'm sure it's going to be something good. Otherwise, They're just trying to keep me out of the pipe because there's something good down there, right?
Nope.
Shocking to hear him swear in the early episodes. Oh, did he swear? I always thought he kind of swore off profanity from the beginning. Alright, we have reached the clock tower. Definitely not from Castlevania. This is a totally an original clock tower. Designed by the creator. Shit. I mean, I shouldn't give the guy guff. I mean, it's not like Castlevania invented clock towers or anything. The perfectly legitimate... Oh god. Thing to put in your video game. Oh god. I think I can get up here. I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, okay. Man, those gear things, or conveyor belts, or whatever they are. Oh, I don't have the clock key yet. Curse you, clock key. Energetic, yeah. He does have a good bit of energy. I watched the Star Tropics thing once, many, many years ago. And push crates, okay. Got it. Time to create? 21 minutes. That's pretty good. Well, not all of that was playing the game, but, still pretty impressive. Can't I just do this? Oh, okay, just drop him in down there. Got it. Hi, secret. Any more secrets? Nope. Aw, can't get up here yet. One thing I'll probably do that might be annoying, or might not, is just hit every single wall in the game with my sword, looking for secrets. Oh, I died so many times here the first time I played this game, until I got used to the kind of wonky jumping physics and stuff. I mean, it's not wonky. I mean, the controls are actually pretty precise. It just, I mean, like any game, it just takes a little getting used to. Alright, need a key to get in there. I just need all sorts of keys. This is also a very referential game, which I can see how that can kind of turn some people off. But my criteria for referential games is, would they hold up even without the references? Like, that's just a generic key, so I guess that's for the door I just hit. Like, a game like, for example, Retro City Rampage, which I haven't played, to be fair, but I've heard some mixed things about. That's a game that seems like it would rely too much on referential humor, and wouldn't necessarily have solid mechanics of its own. From paintings. Oh, I wonder if the Mr. Carpathian hinted at a secret. Don't believe he did. But this game, I feel like I would enjoy it. Like, the references are, I mean, yeah, they're kind of cheesy, but they don't detract from the game for me. I know a lot of people have stronger feelings about that than I do. Oh god. It's a goofy looking skeleton. I like him. I'm sorry I had to kill him. Yeah, I mean, I'm not me. I don't intend to talk shit about RCR since, like I said, I never played it. I was just using it as an example. I'm sure there are better examples if I thought of them. Lonzo, eh? Take this key, I no longer need it. Oh. Okay. Okay, clock tower key. Alright. So now we can backtrack. I mean, I don't have to immediately go back to the clock tower, but there's some pretty good stuff up there, so I will go on ahead and do that now. It'll probably take me about 2 hour streams to get through this game. It's not extremely long, unless I mean, even if you do all the side stuff, all the optional stuff, don't go for 100%. Or, I mean, even if you do all that stuff, it's not an extremely long game. Oh yeah, we have to go back through the loading screen. But, like, I don't mind the backtracking in this game because, like I said, I like the feeling of exploration. I like remembering where stuff is and seeing how places connect and all that stuff. And there is some fast travel in the game. I haven't gotten to a fast travel point yet. Ooh, spooky. Also, I think your clock's broken. The hour hand should not be moving every few seconds like that. You might want to get that checked out. Call a clocksmith. Chainmail. See, I wish I could just go into my menu and look at the stats for it, because I don't see why I should have to get to a checkpoint before I can do that, but... Uh-oh. This is boss number, what, 4? Either 4 or 5. There are a lot of bosses in this game. Every boss gives you a heart container, and, yeah, don't bother trying to attack him when he does that diagonal swoop thing. Every boss gives you a heart container and you win the game with like 50 hit points, so... Quite a few bosses, of varying quality. I wouldn't say any of them are bad, but some of them are more interesting than others. Shit. This boss isn't that hard, it's just, I mean, your instinct is to try to hit him when he does that diagonal swoop, but it's just not worth it. Alright. Like, this boss gave me some trouble. Oh, I didn't actually kill him, so he didn't give me a heart container that time. Storm Eagle, except Owl. Storm Eagle, was that a Mega Man X character? Oh, I can't jump up here yet, but it's a really cool secret once you get past this and you collect a lot of MacGuffins. And it's not really that cool of a secret, but you need it to get 100%. It's cool to be able to say you did it. Alright, so I got the chainmail, and I really should have gone back to a checkpoint before continuing, because I'm already half dead. So I'm gonna have to play a little carefully here, because I mean, if I fall on spikes, then I'm gonna have to fight that boss all over again. So gotta play it a little safely. I don't think there are any major... Yeah, okay. I'm safe. Phew! I like Mega Man X. I haven't played it in a while. One of the few physical SNES cartridges I own. So, 2 armor instead of 1. Reinforced by a link of strong chains. Yep, that's what chainmail is. I guess I can tell how many bosses I fought by how many hit points I have. So, I started with 4, so that means I fought, well, technically 4 bosses, although I did not actually defeat the owl. I have a feeling we will see the owl again before the night is over. Well, maybe not tonight, but before this game is over, let's say. So, I wasn't really sure what to stream. I think I'm a little burnt out on roguelikes for right now, or procedural death labyrinths, or whatever you want to call them. Well, you could have told me that before I got the armor, sir. It's okay. It's worth it. It's worth fighting an owl to get the chainmail. So, yeah, I mean... I might be trying to take on too many PDLs at a time, because I have used to be a mine east of here, but the lizardman took it over. That is a big chest. I cannot get that chest yet. But yeah, I mean, I've got the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I have Ziggurat. I have FTL. I still want to play that. I want to go back to FTL. So yeah, I have a lot of options for procedural Death Labyrinth, but I was kind of in the mood for a game with, you know, a definitive beginning and an end that you just kind of play through once and it's over. I mean, not that I don't still love PDLs, because I do, but I've just been playing an awful lot of them lately. I don't remember what the switch does. I'm sure it's something important, though. Never trust a clockmaker that makes clocks like that. Yeah, I don't know what he's trying to pull. He's trying to pull a fast one. Or she. Burnouts happen, yeah. I mean, honestly, like, I've been a little burned out on video games in general. I haven't been playing nearly as much of them as I normally do, but now that the busy part of the year at work is over, I should be able to get back to them and have a good old time. This guy's 100. No big deal. That's all he has going on. But you know, that's pretty impressive. I mean, I'm sure I won't live to 100, so that guy has accomplished more than me. Ooh, different checkpoint, eh? One I can't activate yet, eh? Yep, that's a warp point. Unfortunately, you need to find two of them before they work. Honestly, I wouldn't want to live to 100 unless I can stay relatively healthy. Just seems like living that long would just be miserable. What's up, dude? Yeah, this dude's kind of a jerk. But you can kill him, so it's all good. I think he comes back. I mean, he doesn't come back immediately, but I believe if I load my game, he'll be there again, and he'll pull the same prank on me again. This is a very Castlevania-looking door. As far as I know, this never actually opens. This is just background decoration. Be cool to get in there. I kind of want to get in there, but you can't. I want to live to 100 years old. Then I can give young adventurers cool stuff and advice. That dude didn't give me advice, though. He just said he's 100. That doesn't help me. Bodley Mansion. Oh, that's a Castlevania 2 thing, correct? Sophia, eh? Well, I will let you know if I run across her. I watched a playthrough of Castlevania 2 recently. Man, that game has some issues. I mean, it was super ambitious and stuff for the time, but it was kind of unplayable. Sadly. Oh god, at least unplayable without consulting a guide, which I consider that to be unplayable. Oh. There's a dude inside that armor. Now he's dead. Are you 100 years old too? That's awful nice of you. Pow. Takes a little while to charge up, but pretty good fireball. This guy is tall. It's a good thing I just got this fireball, huh? Oh god. Thank you. And that doesn't do as much damage, oh god, as I'd like it to. So let's try hitting him a few times. Oh yeah, that's right, that knocks him back. Let me know if this is really loud, and I can turn it down. It sounds really loud to me, but it might just be because of my setup. Oh god. It's a good thing that block falls just a tiny bit to the left. It hits at the edge of that platform before it can land on me. Very convenient. I mean, by the time I beat this boss and can turn the music down, it'll be over anyway, so hopefully it's not too loud. Nice. What was the legal age to view ultra porn? I think it was 120, if I remember correctly. Or no, that's how old Farnsworth was. I think the age for ultra porn might be 90. Aw, empty chest. All I get? Boo. Hey, we're in the next area. Agro's Forest. Ooh, cutscene. Frog wants to kiss the princess, turn her into a frog. But he got scared by a spider, and he fell on his face. That frog is our adversary. By the way, in case it wasn't obvious, I'm just holding down the attack button to use magic. That's all there is to it. It's not like a separate button or anything. Shoot the fireball straight forward. Less straightforward. Oh god. Werewolf. Ooh, he dropped silver. A good farming opportunity early on if you need to farm for money, which I don't know why you would. Well, I mean, if you get to one of the items and you haven't collected enough gold yet, then you might have to do a little bit of farming. I don't think I had to do any in my playthrough. You just kind of collect as much money as you need. Oh god. Blue Hedgehog, eh? Well, that's a thing. If you get too close to those fairies, they say, hey, listen. But they still do damage to you. Oh yeah, it kind of goes through the enemies a little bit. That's nice. Skeleton with a shotgun. I can't get up here yet, can I? I don't think so. Nah. Nice that the game is generous with the save points. Yeah, I never really ran into a situation where I had to do a ton of stuff over again because I died. But at the same time, it does add a little bit of... it does add stakes to the game. It's well designed in that regard, I think. Wait, oh, I guess the fairy's immune to fire? Weird. Oh, here's our first kind of branching path. Do we go left or do we go right? Well, there's a save point to the left, so going ahead and take advantage of that. Actually, let's keep going left for now. I actually forget which way. Oh yeah. You kind of forget about these bosses because you go through this area so many times after you kill them that it's not really connected with the boss in your mind anymore. Some of the bosses it doesn't really make a big deal about. It doesn't change the music or anything. But it still gives you a heart, which is nice.
Oh
Ah, crap, I forgot those things explode. Well, now I have to kill that boss again. See? Like I was just saying. Steaks! Okay, I could go for steak. Huh. Oh, maybe I lied. Maybe I will use this magic more than I thought I would. I kind of remember getting a better spell almost immediately after I got the fireball. Hey, really? That's my fault, because I could have just gone back into the previous room and hit the save point before continuing. So, I'm not putting that one on the game. Hey, it's the spider that scared our frog friend. It really wasn't that much of a threat. Oh, right. I shouldn't really go here yet. This building is really hard. The House of Ruth. Yeah, stuff in here takes a lot of hits and does a lot of damage. Like, that one hit almost killed me. Just to demonstrate, yeah. I will not be visiting the House of Ruth just yet. It is a cool area, though. So see, that's kind of what I meant about how it's not really a Metroidvania. Because there's nothing preventing me from going anywhere in the game. Like, I don't need any... Well, I think there's one area that you need an item to get to. Well, I mean, there's a lot of locked doors and stuff. But, like, as far as major areas go, you can go... Oh. You can go pretty much anywhere. Oh, hey, it's that dude's daughter. Cool. I should go back and talk to him. You can go pretty much anywhere in the game. It's not gated by needing to get certain items. You just might not be able to deal with the monsters in that area yet. So that's the bottleneck. Not like you don't need. It's not like in Metroid where you need missiles to open certain doors, but you don't get missiles until making X amount of progress. I mean, the whole world is pretty much open to you. Just a matter of if you're ready for it or not. Yep, that is a skeleton with a shotgun. Also known as the best enemy in the game. Crap. Let's see. Where am I going? Alright, I believe that is just backtracking, so I need to go forward, press on a little bit. Like it might be a tricky jump. Oh, okay. Well, let's deal with Sonic the safe way. Ow, that thing hurt. Oh well. Save point right here. Can I go here yet? No. Okay, I guess there are kind of a lot of areas. Oh, hey. They're froggy friend. There are kind of a lot of areas gated off by not having the double jump, but once you get... Oh, he is immune to fire. Once you get the double jump, then you can go pretty much anywhere in the game. Crap. Okay. Aw, man, really? He fell down and I got killed by him somehow? Alright, well, I do not want to try to attack the frog from the front. Bad idea. Well, I guess I can shoot a fireball from the front. Oh wait, immune to fire, that's right. Ah! Ah! I was not expecting that either, Bippo. I mean, this boss isn't really that hard. I'm just not playing as carefully as I should. Oh god. Were those his tears? Was it crying because it fell down? Aw, that's kind of sad. Crap. I mean, the safe thing to do is to just wait until he falls down, before you attack. But that takes a long time. Of course, dying repeatedly also takes a long time. So maybe I should. All right, he's dead, or he's not dead. He escaped. Wait, save. Do not forget to save after the boss. Especially when you're almost dead. Man, I have not taught this much in a very long time. And I'm not used to it. Hope I'm not more rambly than usual. Less focused. I just need to get back into the swing of things. Now that the busy season is over, I should be able to do this regularly once again. Oh god. That was a big wood explosion. Cabin key. This cabin's not locked. Hey, what's up, Bagu? I timed that jump poorly. I jumped right into that skeleton's line of fire. And what kind of crazy person gives a skeleton a shotgun? Oh, maybe he had a shotgun when he died, and then when the skeleton came back to life, still had the shotgun. Oh yeah, this guy. The plant just ate that baby. At least I guess it was a baby. He said hello, baby, so. Oh god. Telegraph that move. A thousand years in advance. This guy takes a lot of hits. I wonder if there's a better sword I could have gotten by now. Crap, I might have gone the wrong way. By the end of this game, do all six digits in the money counter see use? I don't think so. Well, I don't know, they might. I don't remember if I got that much money or not. Alright, let's try not taking damage on the way to the boss. So that way I have full health for when I fight the boss. Sounds like a plan. Oh, Little Shop of Horrors, that makes sense. Also, hello, Just Drop. I think I have seen Little Shop of Horrors. It's been a very long time. Save him! Just grab him! Oh. Oh well. Maybe fire works well against this guy. I mean, fire does traditionally work well on plant matter. Oh god. That does seem pretty effective. Probably should have tried that the first time. No, I've never got hit by the baby bones. I'm not sure if they can actually do damage to you or not. How's it going? Not bad. Going a lot better now that work has slowed down. Okay, that's cool. Appreciate you dropping by. New area. Cave of Serpents. This must be the mine full of lizard people that one dude was talking about. These guys seem tough. Fire is not effective. I mean, you think fire would be very effective since they're blue, but it's not following Pokemon rules apparently. Oh god. This reminds me a lot of music from Cave Story. I guess Cave Story is kind of similar to this game, in that it's not really a Metroidvania, but it's still kind of a big open world you can explore. Oh man, am I ready for the Ice Cave yet? Let's give it a shot. Crap! I should probably wait until after I get the Ice Boots before I try the Ice Cave. The first time I played this game, I did the Ice Cave without getting the Ice Boots, and it made it much more difficult. And if I remember correctly, the Ice Boots are not that far away. So, let's revisit the Ice Cave at a later time. You see, there's already two entire areas that I skipped. House of Ruth and the Ice Caves, just because, I'm not quite ready for it yet. Oh, I guess you can't swim. Well, you can't swim yet. Oh yeah, the puzzle. You have to burn the rope, or in this case, cut the rope. Oh hey, it's exactly the thing from Metroid. That's cool. So yeah, very, very referential. Oh god, oh god! There might be... Shit. There was something I wanted to try here, but I didn't do it correctly. If you fall and hold to the right... No? Is this not the right place? Witcher 3 is too damn big. Yeah, that game looks really cool. Probably make my computer cry though if I tried to play it. Alright, let's try this one more time. I might be thinking of a different area. Yeah, I guess I must be thinking of a different area. Lost Vikings LP flashback. Not sure which element is giving you a Lost Vikings flashback. Is it the dying repeatedly? Is that something that happened in Lost Vikings? Especially by me. When you fall, hold left to land on the spring. Oh yeah, I totally forgot about that. I'm amazed that there are people who remember things that I did that I don't remember. Kind of a weird feeling. I'm running pretty low on health. But, I made that apparent. Luckily, you don't lose gold or anything when you die. Not like Shovel Knight in that respect. Not that gold's a huge deal in Shovel Knight or anything. I mean, I guess you lose the gold you collected from the previous save point, but you don't lose, like, a large amount of gold. It doesn't impede your progress in any way. Usually. Music is kind of sad. Yeah, it's a little, it's a bit of a mournful tune. Wait. Shouldn't this be active since I got the other warp point? I did get the other warp point, didn't I? Or did I die and that didn't take effect? Man, if I have to go all the way back to that other warp point, that's a bummer. It should be open. I don't get it. Well, that just took the wind out of my sails. I was going to warp back to town. I mean, I wouldn't accomplish anything, but I could do it. There's like a whole subspace area that you warp into. Like a hub zone, a hub world, sort of. It's like in Chrono Trigger when you travel through time. There's kind of that weird space that's outside of time. And there's some cool stuff down the line. This might be the area I was thinking of, actually. Let me save real quick and try it. So let's see, hold to the right. Nope, that's not it. Is the soundtrack available online? It might be. I'm not actually sure. I believe it is. Oh, another area that we can't go because I can't swim. Wait, I can't jump this, can I? No. Okay, so maybe it is more of a Metroidvania than I was giving it credit for. There are areas that are gated a little bit by not having certain items. I lost a lot of gold in Shovel Knight. Yeah, me too, but that game was always pretty generous with the gold. I never found myself really hurting because of it. Yeah, The Witcher 3 sounds pretty amazing. Soundtrack is on Bandcamp. It says it's $3 Canadian. Yeah, that's a pretty good deal. I do like the music in this game quite a bit. I cut the string. The spider fell. That's cool. A nice little touch. Also, that spider is super fast. Oh, hey. Just chilling, huh? Oh. Fire does not work against this guy either. Oh, but this guy's a pushover. Look at that. Should barely count as a boss. And yet, he still explodes in a shower of money, which I appreciate. Also, that's a very Metroid-esque item get music. Shit. So hopefully, by now, you're kind of getting a feel for how large the world is. Which is the main thing I appreciate about this game. It's just cool to explore. I mean, granted, I've already done this, so it's not quite as cool of a surprise to me, but, hey, there's something... Whoa. Lady has, like, a light bow. Oh, she does look like the princess. It's weird. Boss number what? 12? Kinda lost count. Chad. Are you also immune to fire? Yep. Christ. Damn it. Don't wing at me. Ah. There's almost always a checkpoint right before the boss, which is nice. I don't know why I ran away from the bullet and then didn't jump over it. Wasn't a very good strategy. I like how your projectile is just high enough to be able to hit me. Awfully convenient. I thought there was some trick to those little crabs that he drops. I guess not. I guess you just kind of have to jump over them. Alright, don't get greedy, Duke. Nice. Great. Go back and save. Before I forget, ABS, always be saving. I think it's about time for me to start getting some better equipment. So I was taking an awful lot of hits to die. Don't quite understand what that crab was doing. Well, he was shooting little bubbles at me while summoning spawn from the heavens and winking at me. So that's a good question. Are you the princess? Question mark? Hey, that's where I'm going to. Well, I just want to say we should team up, but okay. Another new area. Ooh, I would like to buy the plate mail armor, but I don't have 1500 gold. Oh, well, thanks for nothing. It's always good advice in this game. Who the heck are you? Alright, it's the book dude. So this is kind of a pointless collectible. I did it. I collected all the pages of the book, but it doesn't really do anything. Yeah, there's 10 of them. Don't really know why that's in there. Just to give you an optional objective, I guess. Something to make it a little harder to 100%. Wish I had thought of calling it the giant enemy crab. I'm sure that's a reference to something I should be familiar with, but I'm not immediately getting the reference. I apologize. Man, I need like 200 more gold to get that armor. That sucks. I thought I'd have enough by now. Well. Crap. Well, stuff's dropping gold now. Actual gold. So it shouldn't take me that long to accumulate enough money. I think this is... Yeah, these are worth way more than the other coins. I think those were copper or something. These are a lot shinier, so they're worth slightly more. Secrets. Okay, yeah, it's not going to take me that long to get the plate mail. From the 2006 Sony E3 conference. Wow. That's a deep cut, Bippo. I do not have that information on recall in my brain. Crap, I might have just screwed myself. Yeah, oh well. Giant enemy crab. And attack the weak point for massive damage. Wait. That's older than 2006, isn't it? Attack the weak point for massive damage? I thought that was actually from an old game. Still running with some pretty shoddy equipment here. Kind of a bummer. Great. And look at how many times I had to hit this thing. I mean, it's not like I can hold a button and just do that. I mean, I'm actually sitting here mashing the attack button. Kinda hard on my poor old thumb. Another new area, by the way. The castle dungeon. I see you, stalactite. Yeah. I'm falling for your tricks. This guy, a pirate? Ah! Awesome. Oh god! Forgot about that. Oh, it's another big thing. And it's a lot faster. I probably have to kill this thing before it has a bunch of fireballs swirling around it. I don't have a rapid fire controller either. That's all Duke Thumb. Alright, I have like one hit point left. Oh hey, what's up, Voxbo? Oh, are you having issues with Twitch? That sucks. Oh god! Checkpoint? Checkpoint? Yeah! Apparently, this guy is Timmy. Or he was Timmy. Oh, it's working? Awesome. Alright, feel a lot better now that I hit that checkpoint. Oof. This guy's big. So you may have noticed that we're already at the eponymous castle in the darkness, which... Oh, snap. That did a lot of damage. And since we're already at the castle, that must mean we've almost beat the game, right? I mean, we're at the castle. Crap! Crap! Oh man, that axe did so much damage. Or torch. I think that's a torch. Jesus Christ. Did Timmy fall down the well? Oh yeah, I guess this is probably a well. It's so dumb. I love it. Let's see if I can fight fire with some fire here. Nope, too soon. Crap. Let's try this. Stick and move. Alright, try not to get hit by this boss. Oh god. Oh, that didn't do as much damage as I thought it did. I guess I was lower on health than I thought I was. I thought that thing did like 3/4 of my life bar. Damn it! Sorry for the silence. I must concentrate on not getting hit. Alright. Now if I go back to that save point, the guy with the torch is going to be back. The frog looked kind of like Wart, and this one looks like Triclide. Oh yeah. Except he only had two heads, so I guess in this case he would be Biclide. Alright, I'm going to risk this guy to go back to the save point. Should have a pretty good positional advantage being on this side. Shit! But I'm still getting hit a ton. Christ. I'm going to be sad if there was a checkpoint right after the boss, though. I can probably skip this guy. Looks like I can just jump over him. What? You're supposed to fly off the screen, jerk. Alright, can't make that jump. I don't think there's anything over there anyway. Who's demoted to a two-headed snake? Yeah, I can see why. Oh god. Gotta fight this dude. I'm running past him. Phew! Tell you what, that's not easy on the thumb. Alright. Mirror's Edge. Look at that. And that's it. Whole dungeon was just to get a sword. But look at how fast I kill that guy now. Amazing. And I have enough money to afford the plate mail. Sweet. I expect I will be coming back here. Because it looks like there was a way I could go that I can jump to. Yeah. Shit. It just mirrored his mask. Look a little bit like Zoidberg. I'm not sure if that's like, I mean, I'm sure that's like breathing holes, like a hockey mask or something. But it looks a little bit like tentacles. Need someone to throw torches at you in a dungeon? Why not Zoidberg? Proficient taftsmanship. Thank you, Bippo. Yeah, I mean, you have to tap pretty quickly. But, you know, I played plenty of Mario Party in my day, so I'm kind of good at those mashing games. Not nearly as good as Mors, though. I call Mors Draconis the master of mashing, at least as far as Mario Party is concerned. There was a minigame from, I think it was Mario Party 1. It was either 1 or 2, where you had to mash the button a lot to wind up one of those flying Shy Guy things, and he always destroyed everyone at that game. Hey, pirate. You wanna jump on the spike again? Or I could just kill you. Easier to just kill you. But my button mashing skills aren't that bad. I kinda wanna get that little toy that they sell in Japan that's just basically an LCD readout and a button, and it just measures how many times you can mash a button. And I think it's 10 seconds or something. See what my actual mashing ability is like. Mario Party 2, yeah. That makes sense, Private Steve. Crap. Alright, well that was the dungeon. And like I said, we will probably go back there at some point. Yep, I always lost to Mors in that one. Alright, let's go back for some plate mail. Ditch this crappy chain mail. And press on into the castle. The castle proper, not this outside courtyard nonsense. You know, a drawbridge is really more traditional than floating platforms, but hey, I'm not going to judge. Oh yeah, some floors can be broken by using an axe. So we may or may not get an axe at some point. Okay, I'll buy some plate mail. Let's check out the stats on this bad boy. 3. Smells strong. In case you weren't aware, 3 is greater than 2. So yeah, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 9 more armors to get, so we're about a third of the way through the game. Well, less than that actually. Since armor is not always given out at a steady pace. Alright, better sword and better armor. We're gonna be rocking this castle. More like Castle in the Dorkness. Cause that's what you got. That's what you guys are. Dorks, I say as my voice cracks. Oh, well. Glad I got the sword and armor before I fought this dude. Not that he looks like much of a threat. But it will be easier to hit him now that I have the slightly extended range on my sword. I can hit him with my flashiness. The little flashy extension off the edge of the sword. Oh crap. Also, this dude is totally from Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past. He's one of the guards who's guarding Princess Zelda the first time you find her. Very early on in the game. Alright, we are trucking. Oh! Ah, yes. Welcome to your doom. Classic. Not quite as much of a classic as Welcome to Die from the X-Men arcade game. I think that's what that was from. Oh god! And just like that, I have to do all that over again. Oh well. Easy come, easy go. Wait. I did not even buy the armor yet. I guess I didn't save after I bought it. There we go. I didn't even see what I died on. I mean, I assume it was spikes. But, it all happened so fast. Like my death flashed before my eyes. Alright, I have to kill this- God! Okay, there are a few frustrating moments like this. Where I just walk into a room and immediately die. And because of that, I have to fight a boss over again. A little frustrating. I know it's my fault, I should have been paying closer attention. Chet. But still. Or maybe, oh god. I was trying to time the jump. But I ended up jumping to my death. Maybe I was just really low on health and I got hit by something. I don't think I was low on health the first time though. Huh, Optimus Prime, I don't know. Might be. It doesn't look like he would make a very good truck though. Oh yeah, I can see what you mean. His head does kind of look like a Transformer. Transformer with a, with one of those Splunkers lights strapped to his head. But yeah, I can't see this dude turning into a truck. Maybe like a Volkswagen Beetle or something. Hear that, green guy? Or a Volkswagen Beetle. I just delivered the ultimate insult. He was so insulted, he exploded. Alright, pay attention, Duke. Oh. Some of these cutscenes you can skip if you've already seen them, but I guess since this one is such a short cutscene, doesn't bother with the skipping. I guess I just jumped on a platform and just fell. That was my fault. Can I jump on this guy? Yeah. No. At some point you can jump on these enemies. I'm not sure what the event that triggers that lets you jump on them is. Alright, I still haven't found a save point, so I still have to, what the heck are you? He's like a centaur with the body of a horse. And the face of a jerk. I knew I should have gone back to the freaking save point. God! Such a long walk to the save point, though. Well, I guess I would have just had to walk back to this area, which I should have done this a long time ago. Jump in here, save, so I don't have quite such a long walk back. I kind of forgot about that save point though, and it's right before the boss. I'm a dummy. Take three. Hopefully the third time will be a charm of some sort. Possibly a heart. Possibly a rainbow. Possibly a pot of gold. But not a red balloon. That's the worst charm. I do not want that lucky charm. Clovers and blue moons I'll take though. Blue moons are pretty good. Is a clover just a shamrock? Or is a shamrock just a clover? Or are they different? Is a shamrock like a big clover? Or is it a totally different thing? I think they might just be the same thing. I mean, they seem kind of interchangeable in Irish iconography. Man, I'm dumb. I should have done this. Oh well. I did buy the armor. Yeah, I saved after I bought the armor that time. Okay. Alright. That is officially the last time we will see this cutscene. So, savor it. I mean, once this is up on YouTube, I guess you can go back and watch it as many times as you want. But it's the last time we'll see the cutscene in this playthrough. I hate the enemies that split off into smaller enemies. Shamrock is a young sprig of clover. So it is just clover. Okay. Good to know. For some reason, I always thought shamrocks were supposed to be really big. Those clovers are pretty tiny, so I imagine a young clover would be even smaller. You dropped a key. Oh. And I immediately used it. Thank you, Bippo. Or as I like to call you, Mr. Wikipedia. You're my eyes and my ears. And while I'm playing a video game, you're my Wikipedia. Oh, there's a switch inside. How am I going to flip that? Good question. Hey, it's a Thwomp. Hi, Thwomp. Whoa. That dude looked like he meant business. This looks like a thing. Yep. Chicken dinner. I believe that gives me a permanent HP upgrade, although I forget how much exactly it is. So this is where you jump on this thing, and I can't do it yet. So yeah, there's something I have to do. That's one of the pages of the Necronomicon that creepy, mysterious person outside the castle gave me. Well, I know not to go in there again. At least, I think once I get the double jump ability, I can bounce on the Goomba's heads. Which hopefully should be coming up pretty soon here. Because once you get the double jump, that's a game changer. You can do all kinds of stuff that you couldn't do before. You can go back to the beginning of the game, back to the town you started in. There's new stuff to do once you get the double jump. It changes everything. Also, it makes getting around a lot easier in general. Mysterious wall chicken. I'll take it. Alright, don't want to go in there yet. I mean, I could, but I wouldn't accomplish anything. It's like, Magic Koopa from Mario World. But this is one of those paintings where I believe there is a secret associated with it, but I think you have to have a certain type of magic that I don't have yet. So we'll be revisiting that room in a bit. Game's kind of an asshole sometimes. I'm not going to mince words. Kind of a jerk. Chicken dinner number 3. I'm gonna be pretty full after all these chicken dinners. And I mean, that's not just a chicken. It's an entire chicken dinner. Including mashed potatoes and gravy and vegetables, all the elements of a dinner. Getting a Castlevania Circle of the Moon vibe. Haven't played that one, but I'm not surprised. Oh hey, I can hit those. I forgot that was a reflectable projectile. Yeah, I never really played any of the Game Boy or DS Castlevanias. Although I heard many of them were pretty good. It was never really on my radar. The only real Castlevania games I played that I put a lot of time into are Castlevania 3 for the NES, and then I did play Symphony of the Night, although I did not make it very far in that one. If I remember correctly, I made it pretty far in Castlevania 3, but that was a long time ago. I don't think I ever finished it. So yeah, I was never a huge Castlevania person. I mean, it seems like a cool series. I did enjoy my time with Symphony of the Night until I got stuck. And I hope Igarashi's Kickstarter for his Castlevania-like game is successful. If it comes out and it's good, I might pick it up. But that's not the kind of game I would actually back on Kickstarter, just because I was never a big Castlevania person. Alright, I don't think I can get that yet, but if I fall... There's a save point right here. I did remember that. Oh man, it's dark in here. I shouldn't have tried that. I guess that's an area that you need the double jump for, but it was too dark for me to see that. Do you need the double jump? I thought you could do this before. Yeah, I don't see a platform to land on. I guess you do need that. What about Yooka-Laylee? I am not a fan of Rare. I didn't like Banjo-Kazooie. They've never been a developer I was really... I never really liked their games. The Donkey Kong Country games on the Super Nintendo were okay. I mean, they're not like... I didn't think they were spectacular or anything. And I kind of hate the way they look. But yeah, Rare, not... Shit. Not really doing it for me. I mean, I hope they're successful too, because obviously there are a lot of people who are into that kind of game. And hey, if it turns out it's really good, I might pick that one up too. Oh god. Me, or is this music way louder than the rest of the music? I mean, I guess it has to be intense because it's a boss fight, but... Oh no, that's cool, Oxbow. I mean, I realize I'm the outlier here. I know Rare is super popular, and their games were beloved. Yeah, I never have any ill will to people for liking something. Unless they like something super racist or something. Then I might have a bit of ill will about that. But more because of their general values than that specific game. Or product. Damn. For a second, I thought I would do this without getting hit. But I had to go and ruin it. Music's fine. Okay, good. Yeah, I didn't like the way the Donkey Kong Country games looked. And I didn't really like the way they controlled either. It always felt really sloppy and... imprecise to me. But hey, what do I know? Oh! I forgot you have to get an item before you can warp. I thought all you had to do was activate two warp points. I'm a dummy. Okay, well... Now I can warp. Oh yeah, the Donkey Kong Country games did have excellent music. So yeah, these are the three warp points we've unlocked: Alexandria, Cave of Serpents, and the castle entrance. So yeah, we're still in the entrance, technically. Well, we haven't even gotten into the castle proper. The Vortex Prism can bring forth the Crystal Tower. Those are some really ominous sounding words. This looks like the kind of place you would expect to find a Crystal Tower. But unfortunately, I do not have a Vortex Prism just yet. But yeah, no reason to go back to town yet, because we still don't have the double jump. wanted it back. Armacrog. Not sure what Armacrog is. The last Kickstarter for a game I backed is a game called Strafe. Now this is straight out of Castlevania. So there are some screens in Symphony of the Night that look pretty much just like this. Ooh. Interesting. Frog is on my level now. Oh, the Neverhood and Skull Monkeys, yeah. Never played those games, but I do know of people who were fond of them. No, the last Kickstarter I backed was for a game called Strafe, which is a first-person shooter that looks very reminiscent of Quake 2. It's kind of, a love letter to the Quake games, the old Quake games. And it looks pretty good. I'm excited for when that comes out. Also, the Castlevania Kickstarter, or not Castlevania, what's it called? Bloodstained, I think. Ritual of the Night Kickstarter. It's the minimum buy-in for actually getting a copy of the game is like $30, which is a bit steep for a Kickstarter. I rarely back Kickstarter for more than like $10 or $15. I mean, not because I'm cheap. I mean, I am kind of cheap, but just for an untested, unfinished product, 30 is a little more than I am prepared to invest. But Strafe was shit. It was $15 to get a copy of the game, which is just the sweet spot for me. I believe the guy who made those games, Bippo, was the same guy who made Earthworm Jim, wasn't he? Or I might be thinking of someone different. Another game I never really played, despite the fact that I had a Genesis. I'm going to skip this cutscene. I'm holding the jump button. It does not want me to skip this cutscene. I mean, it's a really good cutscene. I can see why they want me to watch it, but it's weird that it says hold jump button to skip, but that does not appear to be working. His name is Doug Tinapple, I think. Tinapple. All right, actually, let's pop back real quick and save, just so we don't have to sit through that cutscene every time I die, which I'm sure is going to happen. Let's see, is it faster to go back to the warp zone or to just backtrack a little bit? Probably to backtrack. I think there's a save point pretty close by. Yeah, because there was one right before the boss, right? I mean, I probably would have loved Banjo-Kazooie if I played it when it was new, but I didn't have an N64, so I don't have that nostalgia for it. I only played it when it came out on the Xbox 360, or Xbox Live Arcade, I guess. So played it much later in life. It wasn't one of my formative experiences. Same with the Donkey Kong Country games, really. I didn't play those until much later. So I probably would have appreciated them more if I played them as a kid. Go away. Go away. Crap. Same place I died before. I mean, I'm sure I like a lot of old games that are crap just because I played them when I was a kid. So, definitely it's definitely an experience I can understand. gameplay and not exactly a good game. I'm liking it anyway. Yeah, that is totally a Symphony of the Night corridor. Like Bippo says. Alright, let's see if I can fireball this guy before he does a ton of damage to me. Can I not jump up there? That's really annoying. Oh, for crying out loud. Oh yeah, no doubt, Bippo. I was in the platformers. Whole lot. I mean, I like the original Sonic games on the Genesis. A lot of people say those don't hold up. And, you know, I can kind of see their point. But I love them just the same. Nice, 45 minute demo. I did have friends who had an N64, that's how I play the Mario Party games. I mean, Mario Party, that's a great example of a game that's technically not that good, but I like a lot anyway. You guys really need to calm your shit. Oh, I don't like the looks of this. But yeah, I had a relative with an N64, he just didn't have Banjo-Kazooie. But I played Mario Party, I played Pokemon Snap. That's a cool game. I played the Legend of the Mystical Ninja game that came out on the N64, which was a really weird game, but I enjoyed it. And let's see what else. It's a really terrible fighting game. I can't even remember what it was called. I want to say it was like Dragon Fighters or something like that. Something really generic. It was Dragon something, I believe. But played that one a lot. It's weird, I didn't own a Nintendo console after the NES, but I always had a relative who had one. If I had the chance to play games, I would not otherwise have the chance to get to play. And that's still going on, by the way. I have my aunt and uncle have a Wii U, and I've been playing the hell out of Mario Kart at their place. But I do not actually own, well, I have a 3DS, but it's not really a console. This is a nightmare. I don't want to make this jump. Oh god. The wind-up minigame, yeah. That was not a pleasant experience. Destroying the palm of your hand just to destroy someone in a minigame. And what do you get for it? 10 coins. Awful lot of pain for 10 coins. I picked up Sonic All-Stars Racing because it was on sale on Steam for like $4. And I was like, you know, I really like Mario Kart. This game looks like Mario Kart. I should play this game. And also I've heard good things about it before I bought it. But the game does not play like Mario Kart. I'm not sure if I don't like it or if I just need to get used to it. But the controls are quite a bit different than the Mario Kart. I mean, it does some cool stuff, but yeah, it does not necessarily scratch the same Mario Kart itch. Ooh, this place looks special. I should just get a Wii U. But it just feels like Feels like a bad idea to buy a console like the Wii U when it probably only has a couple years left in it. But there are a bunch of games on it that I really want to play. But it's so much money. Ah, the eternal struggle. It's quite the first world dilemma I have here. Oh. Can't hit this guy unless his eyes open, eh? I don't know what the heck this thing is. A boxing laser cyclops? With some kind of crazy hairstyle? I have no idea. Crap. Oh, come on. Oh, I did not have to jump to hit him with a fireball. That would have been useful knowledge. Yeah, like, they announced some sort of new Nintendo hardware, but I still have no idea what it's actually going to be. Now, the rumor is, or at least the scuttlebutt is, the new Nintendo console is going to be a handheld that you can dock in a dock and connect and play on your TV. That's the buzz going around, because there's some sort of merging of Nintendo's handheld and their console divisions. I'm not exactly sure what the story was there, but there was a little bit of cross-pollination between the handheld and the console side. And if that's the case, I think that's a really good idea. Because the idea of a handheld console that I can also play on my TV with minimal effort seems like a pretty good idea. Hopefully they would focus on not doing a weird gimmick like the Wii and the Wii U did. And don't get me wrong, there are a lot of Wii and Wii U games that I love, but the motion controls did not add anything to the experience, at least in my opinion, and I don't want a tablet that I can play games on the TV. I mean, I realize I was just talking about the idea of a handheld where you can play games on the TV, but a handheld you can take with you out into the world. If you could take the Wii U... Hey! If you could take the Wii U controller out with you, it would be a lot more appealing to me. And if it was smaller. Because it's a little too big for that as it is. Oh god, I am so close to death. Alright, I want to save... Now that I have the green tunic before I fight that Cyclops thing again. I actually don't remember what the deal with this armor is. If it's better than the plate mail or not. I realize this is a lot of backtracking, but I only have one hit point left. Oh god. So, I want to play it safe, especially since I don't want to have to do that jump to get the green tunic again. That was horrendous, but I somehow managed to do it on the first try. It's like Marvin the Martian. With a sword. Instead of a Q42 space modulator. I have a PS4 and I barely play it now. Yeah, there aren't a ton of PS4 games I'm that interested in. Actually, I'm not sure if there are any that aren't also available on the PC. I mean, yeah, I would want to play, like, the remastered version of Last of Us, because that game was pretty cool. Honestly, I think I'd be better off just getting a PS3. Oh wait, I wanted to see what the green tunic does. Because there are so many games for the PS3, and you can pick one up on the cheap now. Or, relatively, on the cheap. I don't remember actually using the green tunic. Courage, wisdom, power. That's better than the plate mail. I wonder if it gives me some kind of special, like if I talk to the Link character in town while wearing the tunic, I wonder if he says something different. I don't think I ever actually tried that. Since I would be like a kindred spirit. Wait, am I going backwards? I'm going backwards. Oh wait, that's right, I fell. I have to go back up and around. Wait. But this is how I backtrack to get to the save point. Oh, that's right. I remember. I have to do that jump with the three stalactites to get back to where I was. I think I'm going the right way. Yeah, that's why I think I'd be better off with the PS3 Oxbow, because then I could just get the original Last of Us. It'd be a lot cheaper. I could play all the other PS3 games I never played. Instead of having to pay for the remaster version. Okay, here we go. Or four stalactites, not three. But then again, I mean, I have an Xbox 360 and I hardly ever use that, so... Maybe I'm just a dyed-in-the-wool PC guy now. I mean, I do like consoles because you never have to worry about, you know, upgrading individual pieces of hardware or anything. And that's why I'm kind of bummed about The Witcher 3, because... I mean, I could probably technically play it, but the frame rate would be so bad. It would just make me... It would make it not a pleasant experience. Whereas if I had an Xbox or a PS4, it might not be a seamless experience, but I would know it's not because of my hardware. I would know, and you know, once they release patches and stuff to clean it up, then it would be a much better experience than I would have on my PS or on my PC. Of course, I could just, instead of buying consoles, just save up $1,000 and buy a new PC, but it's kind of not really an option right now. Jesus, that guy had a lot of hit points. I mean, consoles have their advantages. I'm not like one of those horrible PC master race people who shit on people who play on consoles, but I am much more of a PC person. God, I was right next to a save point when I died too. Well, the original DS had a ton of awesome RPGs and stuff, Galen, if that's what you mean. Well, you can play original DS games on the 3DS as well, but yeah, there were a lot of good games on the DS. I was pretty happy with mine. Now, my 3DS, I don't play nearly as many games on that, although I did just buy Mario Puzzle and Dragons. Aw, another empty chest? That makes me so sad. Oh god. This looks like a job for Fireball. The only problem with getting an original 3DS now is that a lot of games... Nintendo is really bad about, like, letting games become cheap. Like, there are games that go out of print, and then you have to pay way more than they're worth to actually buy a copy. Kind of the one bad thing about Nintendo. There's definitely a, I'm not doing much damage to this thing. Oh, I guess I just... Oh, okay. Hey, what's up, Oblivix? Assmal? I don't see an Assmal. Was it on one of the other heads? But yeah, that was the chest where the frog got the hero armor. Also, the green tunic, the first item to actually change my appearance. Interesting. Just an impulse to buy a thing. Yeah, I get that. I get that a lot, Galen. Like, sometimes I'm just like, screw it. I want a new thing. I'm getting a Wii U. And then I just talk myself out of it. Let's go back and save. Wait, is there a save point nearby? I don't think there's one very close. So I'm going to risk it and press on a little bit. That ass mouth. Oh, okay. You're talking about a meme? I'm not familiar with internet memes, sir. I'm an old man. Rawr, rawr, rawr. Can I fall? I mean, I don't know why I'm asking you. I guess I'm asking myself. I think I need to fall down there, actually. Let's do that. Locked by jail key. Wait. I don't remember a jail. Huh. I wonder if they patched something into the game, or if my memory is just failing me. Oh, yeah, okay. I think I remember the jail now. Get with the maymays. I can't help it, Bippo. I'm an old man. Hey, it's Froggy. Let's, check something out before we talk to Froggy. If I remember correctly, there's something over to the right, if I can get over there. Yeah, I see a wall that's not in great shape. Of course, I want to take damage. I don't think it'll be enough. Well, I can probably, okay, let's do this. Yeah, that's using your noodle, Duke. Oh, it's just a dumb page for the book that I can't even get to because I still don't have the double jump. This game is pretty good, Oxbo. I played the heck out of this game. I think I put about 30 hours into it, not counting what I've done on the stream. Well, that was rude. Oh, thank God. Yeah, I think I haven't played a ton of games that came out this year, but of the ones I played, I think this one is my favorite. Oh, Christ. Yeah, highly recommend picking this up. Alright. If it goes on sale. Alright, got the double jump. Sweet. This game just got started. Alright. Let's see, we're coming up on 2 hours here. So let's use my newly found double jump to show off one more small area of the game. Then I'll call it quits for the night. So yeah, obviously you need to get the double jump to get out of here, so that's why that happened. Actually, I might not even need the double jump. I think I can just jump up there. Yeah. Oh wait, you need the double jump to get up here though. Unless you, well, it just makes it a little easier. Is the wall on the right side of the chest room breakable? I don't think the wall was breakable, but you can do this. 3 pipes. Welcome to Warp Zone. I totally forget which one is the one I want to go in, so I'm going to try all 3 of them sequentially. That's not the one I wanted to go in. And see, that's a totally, I guess it's a bit conspicuous, but, you have to be looking to find that secret wall. Oh, I almost fell in that pipe again. Yeah, here we go. Best part of the game, Glitch World. Oh yeah. Ian's freaking out. We're through the looking glass, people. As far as I can tell, there's no actual point to this area. It's just a fun little Easter egg thing that they put in the game. Or I guess he put in the game. I'm pretty sure this whole game was just made by Matt Cap with no additional personnel. So yeah, if you screw around and glitch world long enough, you eventually die. Hydra Castle game. I think I remember which one you're talking about. Yep. So that's Glitch World. And just for completeness, let's try pipe number 3. See where that takes me. Nothing else over here, is there? No. And that just takes you back to the title screen. Alright, well, that'll do it for this episode of Castle in the Darkness. I hope everyone enjoyed. I like this game a lot. Hopefully you did as well. And I will get back to the game pretty soon. Hopefully in another week or so. Thanks to everyone who came out. It's a lot of fun getting back into the swing of things. Appreciate all of you, and I hope to see all of you really soon. Good night.